You like fireworks?
They're cool.
They're cool? Guess what we're gonna do? Not only are we going to the park, like I said, but they are going to let off fireworks in the middle of the park. We have our snacks mm-hmm. and our blanket. I love this blanket, right? And guess what? Max and Milo are coming. Oh, good. You like them, huh? Mm-hmm. I'm so glad you like them.
Hi. Looks like somebody's gonna have some fun.
Really? Again with the no knocking?
I'm sorry, Milo. Milo let me in. It's about the custody.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Let's go see Max and Milo right now. And, okay, you wanna get the grapes?
Mm-hmm.
You didn't get the grapes, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'll be in there in a minute.
Okay.
I wanted to give you a heads up that Jax has asked that you be put on the witness list.
Yeah, I know. We got the subpoena, Sonny and I.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I tried to get here before that arrived. In any case, I want you to be prepared to be able to tell the court whether or not you think Sonny is a dangerous liability to children.
You miserable dirtbag.
Sonny?
Don't even try to protect. I am gonna kick your self-righteous ass and leave you begging for mercy, you lousy son of a bitch!
This is Sonny Corinthos, Carly's ex-husband.
More than all of me.
You've been trying to bust up my marriage with Brenda ever since we set our vows. Don't think you haven't, Jax.
You mean the day Brenda got into the limo that was wired to explode?
Okay, this custody garbage is ought to cause trouble because you're trying to turn Brenda against me.
All I ask of any of my witnesses is that they be truthful, and
okay.
That's it.
You're causing everybody a lot of pain. And you know what? You're gonna end up feeling it.
No, son. No,
what?
Stop.
I'm sorry that you're having to witness all this.
Who the hell are you?
I'm Grace Yang, the court-appointed mediator.
Jax needs to take me off of that list. Okay, because this is between Jax and Carly. So, I mean, that girl is hostile enough towards me as it is.
She's hostile to everyone, particularly if you're a woman.
Okay, so I don't understand how you can be involved in this at all.
He's my friend. You know, I'm just doing what I can to try to guide him to an equitable arrangement with Carly.
I know, but listen to me. You, along with every other woman in this town, have a child with Sonny. So how can you even speak? Listen, here's the thing. I'm sure you're not surprised to know that I am not going to tell some judge that my husband is dangerous. Okay, how can I do that when I have a child here in this house with him? And this, I think for Jax, is all about getting back at Sonny. Jax needs to take me off of the witness list, period.
Well, if it makes you feel any better, I don't think that his motives are sinister.
Oh, you don't? Okay, look. I completely understand that Jax thinks that Alec and I are in danger and that possibly Jocelyn is in danger as well. But I think that this could be about something else, maybe.
Brent, I'm not going to deny that Jax hates Sonny and would probably be very happy if you left him.
Thank you.
However, he didn't say that to me, exactly.
Oh, okay, well, that means a lot, doesn't it? Look, you have a child just like every other woman in this town with my husband. And if you still can be involved in this, then why don't you go up in the stand and let them question you about how dangerous your child's life is.
Typically, it's frowned upon for an attorney to call herself as a witness.
That's convenient.
I'm just trying to do the right thing for everybody, and at this point, I don't even know what the hell that is anymore.
Miss,
Yang.
Yeah, Miss Yang, we're in a private conversation.
Oh, I think Miss Yang should stay. I don't have a problem with
this. I do. Clearly, you can see there's bad blood between Jax and Sonny because of his wife, Brenda. It's been there for years, long before Jocelyn was born.
I think I've heard enough. It's been very entertaining and enlightening.
That went well.
Your timing could have been a little better.
Why? Now you don't have to impress the mediator because you know she's in his back pocket.
Are you implying that I paid her off?
Yeah, I'm implying it.
I don't need to pay anyone off, Sonny. Is that little tantrum you just threw?
Uh-huh.
That's gonna get me custody of my daughter.
All right.
I hate you.
You just did more damage to Carly's case in front of the mediator than I could ever do in court. Really showed your true colors.
I'd be a little more scared if I were you.
Not scared of you, Sonny.
Okay, here we go. 50-50, last chance. Share custody with Carly.
Or what?
Are you willing to find out?
Thanks to you, by the time all this is finished, I'm going to have sole custody of my daughter.
By the time this is finished, you're going to be done.
Is that a threat?
No, it's a promise. You're going to lose everything. And when you do, you're going to remember this conversation. You know why? You're going to remember that you could have avoided what's going to land on your head.
Okay, guess what? I have a surprise for you.
What?
I made you something. This one's mine, this one's yours, and I put a bunch of cool music on it for you. Here. Ear.
Well, it's easy to do in one ear, you can still hear it.
Yeah, that's a good idea. I'll do mine in one ear, too. You ready? We're ready, Vince. Thank you. Okay, hop in.
Ow!
Thank you. Yeah, just take it.
No, I don't want it.
Okay, you need it, you know, the
way... No, sweetheart, I just said I don't need it. But thank you. I just need to go check on Alan.
You don't want to do that. Not the way you are right now.
What do you mean, not the way I am right now? My son just almost got shot.
Okay, you're okay. Your son's okay.
Okay,
just take...
I'm okay.
How's Alec? He doesn't even know what's going on. So let's... Come on. Just be a few minutes. You find it?
I checked the car and the area around it. The shooter deliberately fired below the windows.
Was the shooter close?
Brendan Alec must have walked right in front of him.
So he could have taken a shot and he didn't. He waited for them to go inside, then he took a shot.
It was meant to scare Brenda.
So you know what we're talking about, right? Somebody's sending a message, and we know who that is, so... we're gonna have to send a message back. You see how fast I got him to sleep?
Yeah, it's sweet the way he responds to you.
How you doing?
I'm fine.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. And this reminds me of that time in your shower.
What do you mean?
In your shower. Those guys broke into your apartment, remember? And shot up the shower while I was in it.
Yeah, that was a long time ago.
Yeah, but I'm just saying that I remember it, you know, like it was yesterday. And... I just had to throw myself on top of my son and hope that I would get shot instead of him.
That should never happen.
Which time?
Both times. I'm sorry for both times.
Oh, thanks for saying that.
No, I mean it. I'm sorry that I had to put you through this, and I'm sorry that you have to feel any kind of fear. But you gotta understand something, that tonight you were never really in any kind of danger. Shooter could have taken you out any time, but he didn't.
I'm sorry, what does that mean? Is that supposed to comfort me?
He wasn't there to shoot you.
Well, then, what'd he do with all those bullets if he wasn't there to shoot me?
Small caliber
bullets. I don't care what size bullets they were. They were bullets, honey, right? Were they real bullets?
Oh, and had a line underneath the window.
Okay, well, Alec could have jumped out of the car or tried to run, and then they may have hit him, right?
The shooter probably would have taken off.
Oh, probably. That's great
news. This was a message... meant for me, that's
all. Yes, sweetheart, I actually think you're right. I think this was a message from your enemies, right? And the message is, guess what, Sonny Corinthos? We can get to your wife and your kids anytime we want.
It's not going to happen. There's not going to be a next time.
Should I bet my child's life on
that? They were trying to make me angry because, you know, that way I would retaliate and make a mistake.
You know, Jax has been telling me this whole time.
Forget Jax for a moment.
How am I supposed to forget Jax, Sonny, when I have to go tomorrow and testify in this hearing?
You don't say anything that happened tonight, okay? We don't go to the cops. Jason, we don't go there. You let me handle it.
How are you gonna handle it?
Look, I just don't want you to say anything about tonight at the hearing. And the rest, trust me, I'll take care of it. Can you do that?
I'm gonna check on Alec.